Hi yoga friends, in this video we're going to look at just two exercises to help keep your knees healthy over time. The first exercise is designed to keep space in the knee joint. Just through life and aging, or if you do any kind of impact sport or exercise, the knee joint tends to get compressed. And when the knee joint is compressed in any way or misaligned, there's friction in the joint. Creates heat, and this is what wears down the cartilage. This is otherwise known as arthritis. Arthritis is a little bit like a time bomb. We might just have symptoms of swelling in our knees, but not really connect with the fact that we're doing damage, because the swelling goes away and the knee can feel fine again. But as we age, there comes a point in life when the cartilage is worn down and all of a sudden you're having this pain that doesn't go away. So this exercise is going to help you keep healthy knees and keep some due space in your joint. The second exercise is designed to help your kneecap track properly in the knee joint. This is another big issue that can happen where it gets off its track. I think of it like a bobsled going down a track, and if it makes one wrong turn or leans too much to one side, it flips out. Danger. And again, the kneecap mistracking may cause some swelling in the knee that goes away, and then you could be fine again. So both of these are exercises to do daily. You can do them a couple times a day. Find ways to integrate them in your day, in your office, at your home, just to keep the knees happy. So whenever you address one joint, you've got to address the joints that are both downstream and upstream. So we're going to look at a little bit for the foot as a warm-up, and then good placement of the hips that supports the knees as well. So let's get started. For this video, you're going to need a tennis ball. I'm using a yoga tune-up therapy ball. If you have one of those, that's great. And you'll need a rolled-up blanket. You can also use a rolled-up towel or yoga mat. It's fine. So here we go. Take your tennis ball. And so for part of this video, you're not going to see my head, but know that it's still there. Take the ball and let's place it underneath the ball mounds of your toes. Heel is on the floor and compress. And then you're going to turn to the little toe side of the foot and the big toe side of the foot. Just bringing some movement in the joint in this direction. So this is inversion and eversion of the foot. If the foot is stiff and doesn't move this way, the knee is going to take some of this torque, and that can be the beginning of some misalignment that can lead to friction and the wearing down of cartilage. Stage two would be to take the ball back towards the heel, but heel is still on the floor, and compressing, and again, the lever is just in a different place when you move the ball forward or back, and we'll do both movements. All right, second side, ball mounts of the toes. I'm trying to make this action come from my ankle and not swiveling my hips to do it, right? This is no. Compress, making an ankle movement. The ankle leads the way. Go back to your heel. The heel is on the floor, but the ball is as far back as you can make it. Back and forth. It's, by the way, a great massage for the foot as well. It's bringing some mobility to some of those joints in the feet. All right, ball aside, take your rolled blanket or yoga mat or towel. And for this exercise, I'd like you to take the first half of your foot up on the rolled blanket, both of them. Bend your knees, and the key here is to take your hips back. We don't want our hips over the ankles, we want them way back. And to straighten your legs, lift your tail up towards the sky. You're gonna pretty immediately feel some stretch. So you may feel stretch in the sole of your foot, your calf, your hamstring, and even up to the low back. You might feel it all. So to reiterate, hips are back, feet are hip width apart and straight ahead, and up on a roll blanket, and we're holding this for 5 to 7 to 10 breaths. Tail up, hips back. feet are in their dorsiflexion position just by virtue of being up on the blanket. Feels really good. All right, to come up, you can step off the blanket and inhale to come up. Next exercise, we're going to the floor. You lie yourself down. One knee's bent, foot on the floor, the other leg is straight and externally rotated. You could do this exercise looking up, but I like your back on the floor, so you can do it this way, or you don't really have to watch, you'll be feeling. Leg is externally rotated, I'm extending long through the leg and lifting it up just to the height of the other knee and lowering it down. This exercise strengthens the medial quadricep and also some of the inner thigh muscles, your adductors. I'm going to do this 5 to 6 times. There is a bit of a way to cheat in this exercise, and I'll show you. If you take your bent knee foot and press it down strongly, it's very easy to lift the leg. So now, lift this foot just slightly, ever so slightly, still brushing the floor. Maybe you can slide a piece of paper underneath. All right, so no pressing down on the foot. That's not allowed, that's a cheat. Externally rotate the leg, extend out long, and slowly lift the leg up, extend out, and slowly lower it down. We're strengthening this muscle in its eccentric action, so it's long and strong. Good function for the muscle this way. And I'm getting really tired doing this again without the cheat. Second side. Leg extends long, externally rotates. This foot, I'm lifting it ever so slightly, just maybe a piece of paper could slide underneath, and then lift your leg to the height of the knee only. Lifting higher will get the hip flexors involved, and we don't want them to be involved in this exercise. 5 to 6 times will be sufficient. You can repeat it 1 or 2 times. Here we go. No pressure on this foot, lift the leg. And when you're done, take the soles of your feet together and relax in bound angle pose. It's always good to stretch a muscle after you strengthen it. All right, yoga friends, do these exercises. Find ways to integrate it into your day. Go to your office desk and lean your hips back and lift your tail. If you can bring a ball to work, put it underneath your foot. A ball under each foot as you lean your hips back and lift your tail. Do this at your kitchen counter. Find ways to get this motion to create space in your knees, in your joint now, and you'll be happy later. Thanks for watching. Check back and let me know how this worked for you. And let me know what you'd like the next video to be on. I have a suggestion for doing a video for good health in your hips and back if you're carrying a baby on one hip all the time. So stay tuned for that one.